In the past three parts, what we have covered? Let us see. In the part 1, we have covered River Ganga from its origin to Allahabad. In the part 2, we have covered the important tributary of River Ganga, which is Yamuna, up to Allahabad. In the part 3, we have sailed along with Ganga from Allahabad to Murshidabad. This is the last of the part. Here, from Murshidabad to Kolkata, we will go. In this part, we will start from Kolkata. Let us see some points about Kolkata. Now it is called as Kolkata, but in the historical past it was called as Kolkata. Now this Kolkata is located on the bank of River Hooghly, and it is in Kolkata that the oldest operating port, which is Diamond Harbour, is located, and it is the sole major riverine port in India. Kolkata is also the cultural capital of India. Kolkata had been nicknamed as the City of Joy. Kolkata served as the British capital for a very long time. Kolkata was formed by amalgamating three important villages. They happen to be Kalikata, Govindapur and Sultanity. In 1690s, the jemindari rights of these three important villages had been taken by the British, and they amalgamated these three villages and formed Kolkata. In 1712, the British completed the construction of Fort Williams at Kolkata, and Kolkata served as the British capital till 1911. Kolkata is the commercial and financial hub of East and Northeast India. It is also home to Kolkata Stock Exchange. The first newspaper in India, which is the Bengal Gazette, was started in Kolkata in the year 1780. Human rickshaw is still in existence in Kolkata. There are many professional institutes in Kolkata, they being Geological Survey of India, Botanical Survey of India, Zoological Survey of India, Anthropological Survey of India, Indian Science Congress Association, Agri-Horticultural Society of India, Kolkata Mathematical Society, etc. There are other cultural institutions in Kolkata also. They include Academy of Fine Arts, A Sadik Society, Indian Museum or the National Museum, National Library of India, etc. Kolkata is also headquarters to the Tea Board of India, Ordnance Factory Board of India. Do you know that the second US consulate in the world was established in Kolkata in the year 1792. It is the second oldest consulate in the world. University of Kolkata was founded in the year 1857. That is the year where the revolt took place in India. The Sipahi Mutiny I am speaking. And it is the first modern university in the whole of South Asia. Victoria Memorial was built during the time of Curzon. It was completed in 1921 using Makrana marble, and it is dedicated to the memory of Queen Victoria. Now it is a museum and a famous tourist destination in Kolkata. Kolkata is also home to many famous modern Indian scholars. Satyendranath Bose was a famous physicist. You must know the famous Bose-Einstein equation is named after this Satyendranath Bose. And also Higgs boson particle, otherwise called as the God particle, which you would have heard, is also associated with Satyendranath Bose. Other important scientist happens to be Jagdish Chandra Bose. Praful Chandra Ray is also known to you, because during the time of Swadeshi movement in 1905, P.C. Ray, Acharya P.C. Ray, started Bengal Chemicals. That is Praful Chandra Ray. And the other important person happens to be P.C. Mahalanobis, who was a statistician who was responsible for establishing the 5-year plans in India. Ravindranath Tagore happens to be a polymath. We have a separate slide for Ravindranath Tagore. We will see about him. And Amartya Sen is a famous Nobel laureate and economist hailed from Bengal. Kolkata also is known for existence of many authors. Iswara Chandra Vidyasagar was a social reformer, and because of him only, the widow remarriage legislation had been passed in the year 1856, also hailed from Kolkata. Another important person happens to be Bakim Chandra Chatterjee, who had authored a book which is called Anand Math. Another person happens to be Michael Madhusudan Dutt, whose Ratnavali is very famous. And Ravindranath Tagore is not only an author, he is a scholar, a guru. We will speak about him a bit later. And Qazi Nazar-ul-Islam is another important person. Sarat Chandra Chattopadhyay is also very important, associated with Kolkata. Now let us see about Ravindranath Tagore. Ravindranath Tagore year happens to be 1861 to 1941. His father is Debendranath Tagore, who was associated with the Brahma Samaj of India. His brother happens to be Satyendranath Tagore, who happens to be the first ICS officer in India. And Ravindranath Tagore has been fondly referred as Gurudev. Rabindranath Tagore is the first person to receive Nobel Prize from India, and he received the Nobel Prize in the field of literature. He received this Nobel Prize for his important work, which is called Gitanjali. He is an exponent of Bengal Renaissance. Rabindranath Tagore is a polymath, and he participated in the Swadeshi movement. Rabindranath Tagore is also credited to have written national anthem for two countries, one being India, which is Janaganamana, and another song which he wrote in the year 1905 during the partition of Bengal. That song happens to be Amar Sonar Bangla. This song became the national anthem of Bangladesh after Bangladesh had been formed in 1971 and later. And he also established a school which is called Shantiniketan. Later it emerged as Vishwa Bharati University. And he is credited with writing many books, which happens to be Gora, Ghare Bare, etc. Other social reformers of Kolkata include Rajaram Mohan Roy, who is considered the first modern man in the modern India. He is the father of Indian Renaissance and founder of Brahma Samaj of India. And it is because of his efforts only Sati had been abolished in the year 1829. Next is Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda assisted the revival of Hinduism. He happens to be a disciple of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. He founded Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission in the year 1896 and 97 respectively. And Swami Vivekananda's important contribution is merging humanism with religion, also merging East and West. He merged past to the present. And it is because of his contributions, Swami Vivekananda's birthday, which is the 12th January, is celebrated as National Youth Day. The other important aspect of Kolkata is the existence of Dakshineshwar Kali Temple. The presiding deity in Dakshineshwar happens to be Bhavatarni, an aspect of Kali. It is in this Dakshineshwar Kali Temple, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was a head priest, and Sarada Devi is also associated with this temple. Kolkata also is known for the existence of the oldest tram in Asia, and it was established in 1873, and the tram is in existence till today, and it is the only city in India where tram is in operative service. Kolkata Metro is the oldest metro system established in India, which was established in 1984. Let us see another important patriot who hailed from Kolkata, Subhash Chandra Bose, 1897 to 1945. Subhash Chandra Bose had been referred as Netaji, and he was the president of Indian National Congress in 1938 and 39 session. In 39 session, he resigned because of some influences, and finally he formed a party which is called Forward Bloc 40. He escaped from India and assisted in the reorganization of the Indian National Army, or INA, which has been popularly referred as Azad Hind Fauj. And he popularized the slogan which is called Jai Hind. And his book include The Indian Struggle. Kolkata also has many GA tags to its name. The mangoes in Kolkata which has got GA tags include Lakshman Bog Mango, Imsagar Mango and Fazli Mango. Other GA tag in Kolkata include Rasgulla, Jayanagarir Mua, Darjeeling Tea and Goinobhog Rice. The saris which got GA tag in Kolkata include Dhanikali Sari, Baluchari Sari and Santipur Saris. Shantiniketan leather goods also received GA tag from Kolkata. Another important painting associated with Kolkata happens to be Kaligat painting. This painting seems to have originated around the 19th century in the vicinity of Kaligat Kali temple. And the important aspect of the painting is the local style, which reflects the mythological themes. So far we have seen all the cities which are found along the banks of River Ganga. Now, Kolkata is the last city to be present in the banks of River Ganga. Now we will see some other aspects associated with River Ganga, the distributaries, delta, etc. The important distributaries of River Ganga include Hooghly River. And in Bangladesh, Ganga is called as Padma. So we'll see from this map, when Ganga enters into Bangladesh, it is called as Padma. And Brahmaputra is named as Jamuna. Both Jamuna and Padma, they merge and take the name Padma. And finally, it joins with another tributary which is called Meghna. And finally, this Meghna reaches the sea. Next, we'll see the submarine fan, which is the Bengal submarine fan. It is the world's largest submarine fan, followed by Indus fan. Submarine fans are known as underwater deltas caused by deposition. It accounts for 10 to 20% of global barrier of organic content. The major crops which are cultivated along the Ganga basin happens to be rice, wheat, sugarcane, pulses, oil seeds, jute, mustard, and potato. We have already discussed about the pilgrimage centers associated with Ganga, and the three important pilgrimage centers happens to be Haridwar, Allahabad, Varanasi. It attracts thousands of pilgrims to this Ganga River every year. Next we'll see Jim Corbett National Park. It is the oldest national park in India and it is located in Uttarakhand. And this park had been established in 1936 and it is named after the famous tiger hunter Jim Corbett. And it is the first park to come under the Project Tiger initiative. The important animal species in Jim Corbett happens to be tiger, Asiatic elephant, sambar deer, etc. Next we'll go to Dudhwa National Park. This Dudhwa National Park is located in the Indo-Nepal border in Uttar Pradesh. This Dudhwa National Park came into existence because of work of Billy Arjun Singh, who became a conservationist from Hunter. And he helped to notify this as a national park in 1977. He was the first to reintroduce tiger and leopard from captivity into the wild, which was a success. Notable animal species in Dudhwa National Park happens to be tigers and leopards. Next, we'll see about Sundarban Delta. Sundarban Delta is one of the world's largest delta. Sundarbans, the name, is derived from a tree which is called Sundari tree. It is one of the natural wonders of the world. It is located in the deltaic region of Padma, Meghna and Brahmaputra river, and it is present both in India and Bangladesh. It contains the world's largest coastal mangrove forest, which extends to approximately 10,000 square kilometer. It is an UNESCO World Heritage as well as Ramsar site. The notable species in Sundarbans happens to be Bengal tiger, salt water crocodile, gangetic dolphin, and the turtle varieties include Oliver Ridley turtle and hawk bill turtle. There are some major threats to Sundarbans. This threat, the important thing which had happened in the past is, in 2007, a cyclone Sidhar damaged 40% of the Sundarbans. And Sundarbans is also suffering from increased salinity due to rising sea level. And poaching is another important threat to this existence of Sundarban and the forest ecosystem. Sundarbans has its own distinct culture. The goddess of Sundarbans happens to be Bon Bibi. And Manasa is another important goddess who is called the deity of the snakes. You must know the Midnight Children book, which was written by Salman Rushdie, is set up in Sundarbans. This book received Booker Prize. It also received the Booker of the Booker Prize as well. Now we'll see some of the flora and fauna associated with Ganga Basin. The important fauna happens to be Bengal tigers. It is a national animal of both India and Bangladesh. It survives only in Sundarbans. The most numerous tiger subspecies in Asia is the Bengal tiger. It ranks among the biggest wild cats. It belongs to the world's charismatic megafauna. And the threat to this Bengal tiger happens to be from poaching and loss of habitat. The other important fauna include gangetic dolphins. They happen to be referred as Susu. And it is the national aquatic animal of India. It is one of the only 5 true freshwater dolphins in the world. And it is related to the much smaller Indus River dolphin. It is endangered due to pollution and overfishing. And we also have other species, namely crocodiles. Gharial crocodiles, mugger crocodiles, salt water crocodiles are other important species in Ganga Basin. Among them, gharial crocodiles happens to be endemic to only India. Ganga River has been subjected to intense pollution. And the sources of pollution happens to be, number one, sewage from the cities along the river. This contributes to one of the major pollutant to the river system. Industrial waste, religious offering, plastic waste, leather tanneries and their waste also contribute to the source of pollution which destroy the river Ganges. And the government has been taking some initiative to save the river. And National Mission for Clean Ganga had been initiated by the government. It aims to clean Ganga and its tributary in a comprehensive manner. And a budget outlay of 20,000 crore had been allotted and it has to be implemented by the Ministry of Water Resources. And we have come to the conclusion of the fourth part of the four-part series of Ganga River and its basin. And I hope these parts are useful to you and you can always refer these parts. Questions can come from these parts which you have spoken. Not only in this Ganga River basin, we have covered all aspects associated with Ganga River and also we have done a video associated with Kaveri. We have done videos associated with history, polity, science and technology, economics, current affairs, etc. Watch all these videos. Many questions may come in the coming preliminary from these videos. Please use these videos to the best of your ability. Please subscribe to our channel. Please share our videos. Keep in touch with us. so that you can watch all our videos which we post on regular basis. Thank you.